Woo!
Best one of all four of them. This is spoiler free. I'm just gonna just let it all out. I am completely taken back by what we got here for Transformers Age of Extinction. It's the change and the direction that the series of the live-action Transformers films needed. It's exactly what needed. What Transformers Age of Extinction does right is it has a much more solid acting, much more of the Transformers themselves, a much more solid plot, and just the overall execution of it. And the fact that it is 3 hours fleshes it out enough so that there is time to tell the story and not make it filled with plot holes like number two was. It just looks really good. All the CGI is fantastic. This movie takes you a lot of places, from the wide open spaces of Texas to the big city, to an alien spaceship, to China. The Transformers, especially Optimus, have a completely different outlook on the humans. They have been oppressed and hunted down to be killed. Optimus and all the Autobots are awesome. My favorite has to be Hound. Hound is actually funny instead of the humor that we got in Revenge of the Fallen. Hound has a very funny sense of military talk and humor. Voiced by John Goodman, so it gives him an edge. And there is a really cool change to the new game that's presented here. New Transformers. I'm not going to say what it is, but when you see it, you're going to be like, wow, that's really cool. I did not expect to see that. And of course, I have to get to it. How are the Dinobots?
T-Rex.
I'm a motherfucking T-Rex!
Awesome. Little spoilers. This is the only thing we'll spoil on. They come in as giant colossal Transformers. They are the Knights. And then Optimus is trying to get them on their side. And then all of a sudden you see one morph into the Grimlock. And they wreck everything up. And it is awesome. And I really hope that they're in number 5 somehow. And they better. And you have to wait a little bit till you actually see the Dinobots. But trust me, they're worth the wait. Get your T-Rex and Spinosaurus and Triceratops and Pterodactyl Transformer action. But the movie as a whole, even though it's 3 hours, some people might say it drags it out, but it does its job and it actually feels like a solid film and you can watch it all the way through without having to cringe the entire time like the other films. Of all of them, this is easily the best one. Solid acting, pretty solid story, awesome action, awesome Autobots and Decepticons and designs and everything. Galvatron is a badass. Grimlock and the other Dinobots are badass. Just the movie is badass. And I didn't think I was going to say that. I was thinking I was going to give this movie like a 5 out of 10 solely because it had good special effects and good explosions. No, I'm giving this a 9. I'm giving this a 9, man. There's absolutely barely anything I can say bad about this as a Transformers film. Of course it has some goofy moments, of course it has some cheesy one-liners, it's a Michael Bay film, but as a Michael Bay film and as a Transformers film, it trumps the other three. And it feels like a really good sci-fi action movie. When Revenge of the Fallen came out, this is the sequel we should have got. And if this is the sequel we would have got right after the first Transformers, the franchise would have much more respect. Much more respect, but as is, this is definitely going to get it back up on its feet and bring back the fan base and say, okay, Michael Bay, you're doing some good here. So, Transformers Age of Extinction, 9 out of 10. Everything is just completely badass about this movie, and I cannot wait for number 5. This has been the Wayfest Review, and we'll see you next time on Team Epic Force. What's the next movie I should review?